So you've aggregated a bunch of data into your Snowflake data cloud. You've run some updates on it, gathered some new insight. Wouldn't it be great if you could get some of those changes back out to your Postgres database? Well, I'm going to show you how today. It's only going to take less than 10 minutes. We'll be able to set up a connector that will stream changes out to a private Postgres database, and you won't need to make any network level changes. But first, let's talk about some of the other options you have to do that today and how Ockam is different. So what are the common options we're looking at? Well, let's start with Private Link and Secure Connect. These are fantastic if you're able to use them. Private Link on Azure and AWS, Secure Connect on GCP. They provide a point-to-point connection from one service in this network here to another service in that network over there. The problem is though, they can be difficult to set up, not technically necessarily, but organizationally. We hear that a lot from customers who have a hard time getting the team to mobilize the network boundary changes required to make a system like that work. The other challenge is you have to be on the same cloud, so you can do an AWS to AWS connection, but it doesn't work if you're multi-cloud or hybrid or on-prem. These are just not options if you're running data centers yourself. What else do we have? VPC peering, a network level connection that allows the network over here to talk to a network over there. Now, problem with this is you're opening up a very big door between these two networks, and you then need to put route tables and config rules and other things in place to try and close that big door that you've opened down to just the two things that wanted to talk. That's the strength of Private Link, is it was just those two things. Network level connections give you a big, big door, and then you try and put rules in place to close it back down to do just the thing that you actually wanted to happen. And VPNs are another solution that I'd put into that bucket, where you're basically doing a network level connection. You're taking a network here, a network there, trying to make them look like one network, and then locking it down so that's not actually what happens. You end up with just the two services talking to each other, not two entire networks. Now, if you're on Snowflake, those two options, understandably, aren't actually options for you. Snowflake don't allow you to do that. They recommend you use Private Link for the reasons we suggested that it was a great solution to begin with. So what's left? A publicly accessible address? The whole reason we put things in private networks in the first place is because we don't want them accessible to the public internet. We're compromising a big security stance here by making these systems available on the public internet in the first place. An IP allow lists, which is basically putting something on the public internet but trying to close it down to only be accessible from one IP address. The problem with that though is even when you think you're only allowing one IP address, that's not one service on the other end. What typically happens at the other end of that connection is that it's a NAT gateway or a proxy or something that is set up to share that IP address across many systems for availability, and lots of good reasons why a company would do that, but it's not one system. You're back to ultimately allowing the entirety of a remote network into your network. That's not what you want. You wanted a service-to-service, a point-to-point connection. So let's talk about how Ockam is different. Like Secure Connect and Private Link, Ockam enables you to create a private point-to-point connection between just two systems, not two entire networks, just the systems that need to communicate with each other. What's more, this works across any cloud, hybrid, on-prem. It will work wherever you need it to work, with any data store or system. Furthermore, the Ockam protocol ensures that this private connection is secure. It is end-to-end encrypted. The Ockam protocol also takes care of a whole bunch of complicated things that make it almost impossible to mess things up and ensure that your systems are secure by design. That includes the way we handle enrollment tickets, and the way that nodes register with a project authority, the way you're able to provide cryptographically attestable attributes to your nodes, and then use those attributes to apply policy-based access controls to further restrict what nodes can communicate with each other. Each node generates its own key so that we never handle the encryption keys for you. And that also means every node and every connection is mutually authenticated, so you have strong cryptographic guarantees about the integrity and authenticity of the data that travels over your connection. The Ockam protocol also includes automatic and regular rotation of the encryption keys, further reducing the risk with all of your private connections. Ockam is the most secure way to connect any two private systems across any network topology. So it's time to get started on sending that data from Snowflake to Postgres. To install the app, go to the Snowflake Marketplace and search for Ockam Push to PostgreSQL. You'll find the marketplace listing like this. Click Get, choose a warehouse, If you need to, click Get Again. This will install the app. Okay, and the app is successfully installed. We now need to configure it. Click the Configure button. And we need to grant the app certain privileges to be able to create a warehouse and a compute pool. Click the Grant button to automatically grant those privileges, and then click Activate. Now we need to launch the app to complete the configuration steps. Now that the app is launched, you'll see a screen explaining some brief details about the app. Go down the bottom and click the Get Started button. Now in this next step, I'm going to show you how to sign up for Ockam and set yourself up as an administrator to your Ockam project. If you've already got an account and you've done that before though, you can skip that and go straight to set a node. You'll need an Ockam account to get started. So go to ockham.io, sign up, and it will give you instructions on how to download Ockam command. You'll see here we're running the install command, it's installing Ockam, and we'll use that to generate the tickets that will connect our services. So here we are, Ockam has been installed. We're going to enroll our local machine as an administrator, and that will allow us to generate the tickets we require. So we've copied the code to the clipboard, continue, we'll confirm the details, and we're all set. If we switch back to the terminal, you'll see that it's signed in and it has activated my local machine. Okay, it's found a project. If you don't have a project already, we'll set one up for you automatically. Now, before we complete this next step, I'm working from the assumption that you already have a Postgres database running in RDS that you want to connect to. If you don't, or you don't want to connect to the one that you have running, I suggest you pause the video now and quickly spin up a test or dev environment that you can test with, and then resume the video once that's complete. At each end of a secure point-to-point connection is an Ockam node, and we're going to set up the first of those for you right now. We're going to run an Ockam node right next to our RDS instance, and any packets that come through are going to be forwarded via the TCP outlet on that node to our Postgres RDS instance. Let's show you how to do that. Once we have a private RDS instance that we wish to connect to, it's time to set up an Ockam node that will serve as an outlet and allow other connections to communicate with that Postgres database. So go to the AWS Marketplace and search for Ockam Postgres. You'll find this marketplace listing, click on it, and then click Continue to subscribe. Then we click Continue to configuration. Okay, and on this screen, ensure you choose the region where your RDS instance is running. In my scenario, it's Northern California, so we're choosing US West California. Click Continue to launch. And then the launch button. This will start a CloudFormation template that will run us through setting up a managed node for you. Just accept the defaults on this page. All right, let's give this stack a name. It will appear in various places within the Amazon UI, and it will make it easier for it to decommission all these resources if we don't need them later. So Postgres demo, I choose the VPC where my RDS instance is running, and then I choose the subnet where one of those instances is available. And MX8 large is too big for my needs, and dropping it down to just a large. And now we need to provide an enrollment ticket. This enrollment ticket is what allows our node to register with our Ockam project. So we'll switch to a terminal and we'll generate that ticket now. Okay, so I'm generating a new ticket for my project. I'm saying this ticket is only allowed to be used once and it must be used within 24 hours. We're also putting an attribute on whatever node registers using this ticket, and that attribute will be Postgres. And we've also given it the shorthand form here to say it is permitted to create a relay called Postgres. The output of that command we then pipe into a file called postgres.ticket. I'm then going to copy that file to my clipboard and we'll paste it into the CloudFormation configuration screen. now need to provide the endpoint to access the RDS instance. You'll find that on the client information page within your RDS screen for that particular resource. And the JSON node configuration that will pass the Ockam command when it starts up. This instructs the node to create a relay named Postgres to create a TCP outlet that will forward to the database endpoint we've just specified in the field above that, and to only allow access to that endpoint to a node that has the attribute Snowflake. You can either copy these values here from this video, or if you look at our docs page for this scenario, you'll see a template that you can use. Click Next. I'm fine with all the defaults on this page. I acknowledge that it can create resources and submit. A stack creation process will start. Within a few minutes, this node will be up and running and created an outlet that allows us to connect to our RDS database. Now it's time to complete the Snowflake side of this setup. We're going to run an Ockam node in a container on Snowflake, register it with our Ockam project, and it's going to be able to establish a point-to-point connection with the node that's running over near RDS. The Ockam node that we're going to run in Snowflake is going to need to be able to register with our Ockam project. To allow it to do that, we create an enrollment ticket. So we're going to switch to a terminal and run Ockam project ticket to generate a new ticket that we can use to enroll. We specify here a usage count of 1, which means this is a single use ticket. It cannot be redeemed a second time by any other node. And we say it expires in 2 hours. So for it to be used at all, it must be used within that 2 hour window. This helps improve our security posture and reduces the risk of this enrollment ticket being used in ways we do not expect. We also specify that we want any node that registers with this ticket to have the attribute Snowflake applied to it. We then pipe the output of this command to a file called snowflake.ticket. I'm then going to copy the contents of that file to my clipboard. We'll switch back to the configuration screen and paste the value in there. Click Next. Okay, now we need to provide the rest of the configuration details. Provide the database name on the Postgres side. I'm just still using the Postgres database, but if you're using something else, provide that here. And now we need to map the streams in Snowflake to the tables in Postgres. Now, if you have a stream already set up, you can use that. Otherwise, I'm going to create one now. So we'll switch to a worksheet. And I'm going to create a table called Customers with a few fields. And then I'm going to create a stream on that table called Customers Stream. So the stream is called Customer Stream. Let's remember that. So the left-hand side here is the Snowflake information. So we'll put in our database schema and stream name. Okay, demo test, public, and customer stream was the name of the stream. And then on the Postgres side, we need a table with the same fields in the same order to be created. So let's switch over to Postgres and we'll create the matching table right now. Okay, so we need to create a table, customers, and we had an, if you recall, an ID, a name, and an email. So let's put those fields on now. So ID is an int, name, just do a varchar, and email. Okay, done. We'll switch back. And public.customers was the table we created there. Click the plus button to add that to the mapping. Okay, click Next. It grants and privileges the application for it to be able to reach our Ockam project. So click the toggles here. You need to provide your Postgres credentials so that we can connect. So enter the username and password that has permission to access the table we just created. Click Configure. Click Connect to allow the egress. Okay, and that has been applied successfully. We now need to grant some additional privileges to the application on the stream itself. To make this easier to add permissions to future streams we might use, we're first going to create a store procedure that we can then call with the values that we require. So expand this, copy the entire stored procedure, let's switch back to our worksheet, create the stored proc. Okay, that's done. Switch back. And now we're going to actually run that with the value. So we're going to grant the permissions onto the stream we created. So demo test public customer stream that has been successfully granted. And we can just double check that by running this command. And we should be able to see that there's 6 different permissions that have been granted there. Excellent. Click next. The app will take some time to start. So I'm going to skip ahead in the video here so you don't have to wait around for the 10 or so minutes that this takes. And the app is successfully installed. You'll get this success screen at the end here showing that it's running, that the portal is up, and the Postgres client has been able to connect. And you're now streaming messages from Snowflake to Postgres. So let's have a quick recap on what we've achieved so far. We created the table in Snowflake, added a stream to that table, created a corresponding table over in Postgres. We've set up a node next to our RDS instance and another in our Snowflake warehouse to establish a secure point-to-point connection. And now the Snowflake app is taking those changed data capture records and automatically populating the table over in Postgres. All that's left is to show you in action. Okay, so let's prove that it works. Over in a Snowflake worksheet, I'm going to insert into the customers table. Here are some values here. Now remember, there's a stream attached to this table called customer stream, which will be a stream of changed data capture records that will be published to our Postgres app that we've installed in the Snowflake Marketplace. That app will then publish them over our point-to-point secure connection to our RDS instance. So if we run this command, what we'll see is that one row has been entered. Now if we switch to our Postgres client and query our table, we'll see that that record's there. Let's insert a new value. Okay, we're going to add Bob and Bob at Ockham. We'll run this. Again, one record's been inserted. Query, it wasn't there the first time. Took a second or two, it got there eventually. And just to round out the trip, let's delete all records in the customer table. Run that. Query, it's still there, still there, still there. And they're gone now. Now, if you remove all the explanation and commentary from me about what we've been doing today, and the time spent waiting for containers to start up, in just a couple of minutes of configuration, we've been able to establish a point-to-point connection between two private systems. Our Snowflake warehouse is able to connect to another data source. We haven't connected two networks. We haven't exposed any of our services to the public internet. We're not having to manage IP allow lists. It's a point-to-point connection, much like Private Link or Secure Connect. But it works across any cloud, on-prem, or any kind of hybrid environment. Furthermore, it's a secure connection because the communication is end-to-end encrypted, with each node generating its own encryption keys and sharing those in a way that means Ockham never has access to those keys. And the keys are automatically and regularly rotated for you too. Ockham is the most secure way to connect any private systems. Use it today. If you haven't been following along, please, what are you waiting for? We'd love to hear your feedback. For more information, check out our homepage, www.ockham.io.